Welcome everyone to another episode of Unscripted and Unchained RPG Review. I am Game Master Bloodworth, and as you can see by the graphics, today I'm going to start off with the Let's Find Out. We're going to be taking a look at how to make RPG adventures and campaigns, a Game Master's Guide. This is my first look at it, although I will talk about the table of contents and really my reaction to the first time that I saw the table of contents. But for the channel, this is the first look. So this is a small booklet, and I'm going to switch views and go over this a little bit with you as well. But it is 45 pages with advice, and that advice is on how to make adventures and campaigns for fantasy RPGs. Now, even though this is attached to Mifrog, as far as some of the game mechanics that it does mention, it is fully compatible to any D20 system and also any D100 system or percentile system with very, very simple conversions. And when you take some of the mechanics of Mifrog, such as OV, which is offensive value, or DV, which is defensive value, you're basically talking about your pluses to hit, and you know your pluses to hit is offensive value, and DV is your defensive value. So a combination of your armor class and or modifiers to that as well. But the advice, you know, and the page tools, 75 pages worth of tools, from random NPC demeanors, objectives, motivations, personality traits, flaws, secrets, and then there is separate sections on traps, so random traps, poisons, diseases, encounter locations, events, names, and much, much more. So this is 127 pages of content, and very, very little wasted space. It is going directly into the rules and suggestions and advice that is in here. So no imagery in it whatsoever, as far as photographs or pictures or art or anything like that. Just straight up content, 127 pages worth. So let me switch views here and show off the booklet a little bit. So this is €9.99. I bought it on Amazon for $10. All right, printed here in the United States in North Haven, Connecticut. So it arrived to me very, very quickly. I ordered it on the 14th, or it was printed on the 14th, and I probably had this by the 16th, within like 2 days. Maybe 3 days ago I got this. But I wanted to just go over the table of contents and what it really, what really drove home to me as soon as I looked at the table of contents. So I'm going to switch views. So here's the table of contents. Now, the one thing about any of Varg's things on Amazon or elsewhere, the PDFs are usually not available for his rule books and supplements and such. Occasionally you can go to the website and you can find on his website, you can find PDFs of various game materials, you know, such as character sheets, both form fillable and not, and whatnot, maps and such as well. And on occasion, several adventures that you could also print directly off of there. But he does not do PDF. And so I can't bring up PDF. So all I did was I took a picture of the table of contents here for you. So the contents. Now, when I started reading this, I had the I'm surprised. And then all of a sudden, I questioned myself as to why am I surprised? Because this just looking at the table of contents struck me as being the most relevant and important advice that a book can deliver to new game masters. And, you know, it really made me, you know, surprised, number one, how effective that just the categories of what the book is talking about, how effective that will be in training new game masters, you know, giving them a really valuable guide. But it made me say to myself, why am I still surprised? Varg Vikernes is an exceptionally good game designer, you know, and we shouldn't be surprised by that any longer. I mean, if you follow the evolution of the Mythrock game system from, you know, its first edition, which, yes, agreeable, there was a lot of things that were really not working well in that system. But if you follow that all the way through to where it stands now with the special edition version, or edition of it, which is 4.0 special edition, the game system has gone through an incredible improvement evolution in it. So I shouldn't be surprised any longer, and I won't be surprised any longer at this man's brilliance in writing, you know, game systems that really work and giving great advice. So let's take a look at this. So he has the introduction, and it's a very simple introduction that talks about, you know, what is role-playing and that kind of stuff. Fine. That you're going to see in every other book as well, that's giving you tips and hints on how to be a game master. Why make your own adventures and campaigns? That is a question you don't often see, and I don't recall having ever seen that question put in a book. Why make your own adventures and campaigns? This is a really important question to put out there, and it's something that I think more game masters out there need to be encouraged to do. They need to be told that, you know, this is an important skill ladder that you need to climb to the top of, and along the way is making your own adventures and campaigns and world settings and such. It is delving deeper into the creative process, and you're going to get so much more out of this hobby, all right, if you are creating your own things. All right, now he will go into, because I looked at some of the other statements that he makes in here and the advice that he makes in here, and he talks about using officially published works. He talks about using modules or adventure paths or, you know, campaign books and whatnot. And he basically says, that's fine to use those things, but he has never had the experience, and nor have I, ever not done this as well. He has never had the experience of anybody running an adventure straight from the module, word for word. Modules are oftentimes just bastardized for their content, you know, stripped out and reimagined, reused, repurposed, and then repackaged into something that fits within your own campaign, within your world setting. So again, just really, really great advice talking about why it's important to make your own adventures and campaigns. And I did read that section there, but as soon as I read this one bullet point, let's say, in the table of contents, I was like, I need to see more. I need to see what he's actually talking about. Player dynamics also comes into play, and he gives advice about player dynamics. I have not delved into that yet, so I will be doing this as a walkthrough. This is only just the first look. Developing the world. Engaging NPCs. So what is an engaging NPC? Adventure plots. Sample NPC patron. As soon as I saw the term patron, that told me that this is a relationship that the player characters are going to develop with an NPC patron that is going to be kind of their guide in the world. This is the person that is going to give them mission, tasks to do. It's someone that the players can rely on for their characters to go back to this patron and receive assistance or guidance or advice as to what they should do next. So it is really creating the interaction as an important one for the players and their characters in developing a long-term campaign. Adventure plots are clearly defined, adventure preparation, story arcs, encounter design, balancing challenges. Like I said, I'm going to go through all of these along the way. Rewards, player agency, and improvisation. So yet another really important concept for any game master to keep in mind. You know, how much player agency can I give at the highest level without interfering too much with the campaign and the world setting? So it's a balance, and it's one where you want to favor player agency a little bit higher, and we'll see how far he goes with that and how he's going to describe that, which is why I entitled this "Let's Find Out." You know, let's check this stuff out as we go through this. And I got to keep on asking that question just before the section. Overcoming setbacks. So how do the player characters respond to failing a mission? All right, and so hopefully that's going to be detailed in there as well. Resources and tools, a sample mini dungeon. All right, great. It's always good to see samples of things. Then you have time. Big question about time. Within the hobby, one-to-one time and such, you know, and so forth. You know, how do you track time in your game world is super, super important. Campaign time is also very, very important as well. The repetition and balancing encounters, old friends and enemies. All right, so here again, it sparked my interest. I looked at it really quickly, and he's talking about the game master note taking the important friends and enemies that the player characters encounter along the way, so that these become recurring characters in the player or the adventure parties. I'll start calling it the adventure parties. The adventure parties experience through the world. You know, as they're going through their campaign, as they're going through the world setting, and they may come into contact with these individuals, over and over again. And that's really important to make the world feel like it's a living, breathing place. All right, organizations, we'll go into detail there. Player duties, so it's getting back into the meta part. What is the player's duties? And we'll go into that in more detail. Multiple player characters. So yeah, how do you have your players utilizing multiple player characters? Do those characters know each other? Are those characters completely separate from one another? They're most likely occupying the same timeline and same game world, do the actions of one impact the others and whatnot? So we'll go a deeper dive into that section as well. The game system and setting. Then we go into the appendix, and we go into the various tools, right? So NPC generation, which every game system has, their appearance, their age and experience level, their homeland, their random flaws, NPC character roles, their classes and or professions, their equipment, their demeanors, their personal traits, their objectives, their motivations, and the NPC relationship changes. You know, so is there some way that an NPC's relationship with the player character is going to change? That should always be the case. All right. And then we go into NPC names, and there are various, you know, Thulian names that's set to the Mifrog system, but you can utilize those elsewhere as well. Then you go into Dwarven names, Gnomish names, male Orcish names, female Orcish names, male halflings, female halflings, Elvish names, and so on and so forth. Then we go into encounter behavior, encounter nature of encounters, encounter locations, random events, random poisons, random diseases, random traps, and then finally, random NPC secrets. So when I first started glancing through this table of contents, it really did genuinely make me say, wow, this is really, for just 127 pages, this is really hitting all the points that I think a very good Game Master's Guide should hit when talking about creating adventures and campaigns. And a world setting as well as campaigns. So it's I think the advice here is very, very high value. And in such a small, and I will switch back here, in such a small, compact little book here, and for literally for $10, it is, you know, it's something I wish I had seen back in May when this was originally released, but I'm certainly glad that I have come across it now. Now, one of the things I'm going to do, because I just recently picked up before my vacation a couple of weeks ago, I picked up So You Want to Be a Game Master. And I will be doing a comparison. Now, for those of you out there who are saying, oh my gosh, you're going to take Justin Alexander and any award-winning, you know, YouTuber and blogger and, you know, and game designer and book writer, and you're going to compare it to this here, yes, I am. Because I can see, just comparing the two table of contents, that this will probably be certainly more useful to me and probably more useful to a number of other individuals as well. So not to take away from this, and I haven't started really digging into this yet either, but I will be doing a side-by-side comparison between the two. And, you know, I can see the legitimacy in doing that. So this is just a first look, and it's a preview of what is to come as far as I start digging through deeper into this, you know, into how to make RPG adventures and campaigns. And if you subscribe and hit the alert buttons, you will be notified as to when those videos and others drop as well. I want to thank everyone for joining in. As always, I look forward to seeing you on the gaming screen or at a gaming table at a convention sometime soon. And enjoy the rest of your day. Please feel free to put your comments in the comments section. I really enjoy those and try to respond to them as quickly as I possibly can. And you know, like the video and share the video if you wish to do so. I have been recently, just to give you a little bit behind the scenes kind of thing, I have recently been making all of my videos listed under Creative Commons. So you are able to actually take my video and, you know, and snip it and use it in your own commentary if you wish. And there'll be no issues with that, because ultimately I think it helps us both out. You know, to be honest with you, you'll use my video and make your commentary, and then Others will see it, and then they'll see where it originally came from, and then they can come back here and see the full view of the video as well, plus any follow-ups that I do. So you're certainly welcome to do that. It's a change that I made quite a while back. I changed a whole bunch of videos and made them all Creative Commons. So yeah, you can definitely borrow my stuff and you can use it and put it out there. And you know, all that I ask is that you, you just put a little thing in there that says where it came from so that they know how to find it and take a look at the full form if that's what they wish to do. So again, thanks for stopping in. You will have a great rest of your day. Take care.